PangoScript is an internal scripting language for Beyond, which allows users to control all elements of Beyond in a script format. This allows users to create exact sequences, control hidden variables, make custom schedules, interfaces, and much more. Like the universal effect pool, PangoScript is a universal system and has the same full functionality in all places where you can use PangoScript. And where can you use PangoScript? Well, the first and main area where you want to use PangoScript is under the PangoScript tab on the right. Here you can add new scripts, edit scripts, move them up and down, see Script Task Manager, and stop all scripts here. But you can also find scripts in queues, in timeline events, and in conjunction with other protocols like DMX, MIDI, and OSC. And there's other areas as well. One last thing we want to do before we start scripting is enable some options for the preview window. Go to Settings, Configuration, Laser Preview, and enable Display Internal Beyond Command. This enables a preview of internal Beyond commands in the preview window as you use them. For example, when you enable a queue, it will show you all of the internal Beyond commands that made it happen. These commands listed all can be used inside of PangoScript, and is a great way to learn commands inside of Beyond and figure out what commands do what. To start, let's go under the PangoScript tab and create a new script. This will open the PangoScript editor window. If you edit a script anywhere, this is the window you will use. On the top, you have your standard New, Open, and Save. Under Run, you have options to start and test your code. And under Tools, you have some options to help you create your script. Across the top, we have a few other options, just like the ones under the dropdowns. Last thing to note is the top is the Object Tree button. The Object Tree is where all parameters inside of Beyond can be found, and you use this tree to find and grab the code for those parameters. To the right of this window, you have a lot of your commands that you can use in PangoScript grouped together. Feel free to look around these to find commands you may want to use. You can also go under the Command List tab and search for something you may want to do, like Wait for Time, or DMX-related commands, or MIDI commands. You can double-click any of these to add them to your script. On the bottom, you have an information panel. Usually you will leave this on Help, as you can click through the commands on the right, it will move through the help file and explain what different commands do. Lastly is your main window where your script will be displayed. In blue will be all correct code, red will be user input data, green will be correct values, and cyan will be correct states. If Beyond senses your syntax is incorrect, it'll highlight the text in red like so. In order to help you understand PangoScript as fast as possible, we'll just look at code examples, which should help you get going with your scripting. In our first example, we have written a script that when we open Beyond, it'll automatically start using the auto start command, and then go through a few options to get us going, like enabling laser output and enabling DMX input. Plus, at the end, we have a command to start another script, which is our second example. In our second example, we have made a theoretical schedule script, which could be used for an install. First, we wait for the specific time of day and start the first queue. Let's say that first queue is a timeline queue, and after a few minutes it'll end. Our next command waits for that queue to end, and then starts the next queue. This queue could be just a looping logo maybe, so at 22 hours we want it to stop the queue. Lastly, we want this to restart the computer and start back up the next day. So we'll wait for just before midnight, and restart the PC using our runapp command and using an internal Windows command here. After we start that restart into motion, we close Beyond and the PC will restart. Now we can look at some timeline examples. This very simple example is a code that automatically saves your timeline for you when you start the code. It'll quick save, then after sleeping for 5 minutes, it'll restart the code, doing another quick save. Note, when it quick saves, it'll stop playback. Our fourth example shows how you can create a shortcut macro using PangoScript. Here we'll pause timeline playback, bring the cursor back to the beginning, and play for the beginning all from one script, cutting out a number of steps and clicks in the process. Lastly, let's look at the scripts that are part of our default APC40 Mark II map. Our BeatSync rebutton and our Enable Laser Output buttons are just short scripts seen here. And some of our control sliders like Zoom are just scripts here like so, and change with the control change. Thanks for watching our quick hints video on PangoScript. If you still need help, feel free to contact our support line by emailing support@pangolin.com or watch other videos we have that show examples of PangoScript being used.